On Tuesday evening, multiple individuals sustained gunshot injuries following a drive-by shooting at Ciceron streets. According to reports, at about 7:30, shooters opened fire near the old Capital Management building behind me, injuring four individuals. Two victims received fatal injuries, while one was transported to a nearby medical facility in critical condition.
The responding crews were informed that four individuals were injured in the incident. One male individual, appearing to be in his 30s, was found lying on his back complaining of pain to the area. He was immediately transferred to an awaiting ambulance for further assessment and treatment. Another male individual walked towards one of the responding ambulances, nursing a wound to one of his arms. An assessment of that patient revealed that he sustained a wound in the area and a laceration to one of his legs. Both of the patients were transported to the OKEU hospital in a stable condition. Two other victims who were pronounced dead on the scene by a medical doctor were left in the care of members of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force.
The victims have been identified as 45-year-old Timothy Gilbert and 44-year-old Simeon Seytout, both residents of Ciceron. Their families are at pains to understand why anyone would want to harm them. Timothy Gilbert's older brother, Desmond Gilbert, says he was home when he heard the gunshots echo through the community, not giving thought to the possibility of a loved one being caught in the hail.
I stayed home and I heard the shots. After hearing the shots, I came by the road and I see my brother got shot. He fit in the jail. Actually, there was three guys lying there. Yeah. And when I come, I saw that he fit in the drain right there. Really and truly, we all are broken. All are broken. We just cannot cope with it right now. Probably, well, time will heal after a while, but you know, certain things like that doesn't heal, you know. There's just a pain in your heart for all the time. He's one of my favorite brothers, you know. Understand, always cracking joke and giving joke. And yesterday after work, you know, I met with him, they crack a little joke, and then I went to him, yeah. He's a down-to-earth guy, not in problem with anybody, you understand? But I cannot understand why them fellas had to do him or not. Whoever did it, I don't know.
The brother of Simeon Seytout, Sean St. Rose, says his brother was full of life, always putting a smile on faces. For that, he was well known and loved by everyone.
I was here, and one of my brother told me there's a shooting down the road. He told me, well, he knows it's our brother, so when we went down there, we see he was already dead. His name is Simeon Seytout. I don't know him to be a bad person or anything. I just know he's an Irishman. He knows everybody from the area. So he always going down the road, and we hear that. We're saddened by that, but it happened already. We can change that. We had breaking, you know, we didn't expect that to happen, so we're trying to cope with what had happened already, so we're just holding on. He's a real guy, he's friendly, he's loving, he's the one of those that keeping things alive around here. Around here quiet, he's the one that just making noise and, yeah. But he's a good guy, we'll miss him very, very, very much.
Both families have called for an end to the gun violence plaguing the island as they join the crowded list of relatives seeking justice for their murdered loved ones.
I never thought my brother would have gone down there, and I going through that something that I never got healed, because at least three or two years back, my son got shot the same way. Understand? My son got shot the same way at Bexo. Understand? And it's very painful, my brother, which is, I don't know. I don't know why the youths and them don't want to get up and do something. Get themselves busy. You know, put down the gun, because them violence ain't make no sense. It ain't make no sense. It's the family that getting hurt all the time. Every time it's the family that's suffering the consequences.
I don't know how that going to stop in St. Lucia, the crime, the gun violence. Just, I don't know what to say to you about that, because it's just not happening. It's not stopping. When you hear, I heard things in full show, then I get something in Ciceron that you never know where again you're going to. So it's, the young fellas now just have to think about what they're doing.
The Royal St. Lucia Police Force is continuing investigations into the matter. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.